Hey, what's up? It's Mike Icee, and today we're going to go over a brake fluid flush for the W212 E-Class Mercedes-Benz. So don't worry, we're going to go step by step, and I have everything here if I can get the whole step by steps on the bottom right there. But before we do that, okay, first of all, what parts do you need? You need this right here. This is the brake fluid, which is .4+. This is 1 liter, and the capacity of the system is a half liter, or roughly a little bit more than half a quart. So this is enough to flush your system and to replace the fluid with new fluid. Now, the tools you'll need is a syringe or a turkey baster, an 11 millimeter wrench, open end wrench, a towel, and then you need a hose and a collection basin or a some bottles. You need something to collect the fluid, okay? And we're gonna go step by step. So there are two components to this thing. First, we're gonna have to, and don't worry, you don't need all these fancy tools. Basically, the first thing you're gonna do is you're going to suck out as much of the used fluid as possible from the reservoir, okay? After that, what you're gonna do is you're gonna top it off with new fluid, okay? And then you're gonna work your way around. I know typically the American way is you start from the furthest away wheel and then you work your way around back to the closest wheel. The Soviet method is the opposite. The Soviet method is you start at the driver's side wheel and then you work your way counterclockwise. So you do driver's wheel, then you do the driver's side rear wheel, then you do the passenger side left wheel, and then you do the passenger side wheel. After you put on, and I'll show you how to do this, you put on the hose and you undo the bleeder bolt, you'll just let gravity do the work, okay? It is your job to do two things. First of all, make sure that your reservoir cap is off, okay? And then make sure, okay, it's very important that the fluid, make sure that the fluid never drops below the min line, right? It could go a little bit below the min line, but just consider that min line as the absolute min that you could have the system in, because you don't want to introduce any of the air into the system from the top, right? Because that's the worst place for the air, because then you'll have to push it all the way out, which is going to be a lot of crazy work. Okay, here you can see I'm undoing the cap, and I put that towel all around so that when I refill the tank, I don't have to worry about fluid spilling and damaging anything. Okay, I'm grabbing the syringe and I'm extracting the fluid. I'm gonna extract a total of 180 cc's. This will vary. Keep in mind, you don't really wanna go below the min mark on the reservoir.
We do another one, like this, that's 100 milliliters.
Okay, I'm on my third syringe, which is 150 cc's out of 500. We're almost to the minimum. Okay, so I've taken out a total of 180 cc's. 36% of the brake fluid has been removed now. I'm gonna pour in fresh fluid. Okay, I'm adding in fresh fluid. Keep in mind, I did not fast forward this part because I wanna make sure you understand that you have to fill it up to the max mark on the reservoir, or you could go a little higher because you're gonna bleed the system anyway. Or you're not bleeding the system, you're flushing the system. There's a big difference. Okay, here I am showing you where the dust covers are for the bleeders. There's one in the front, one in the back. The back is gonna be right here. All right, we'll be ready to bleed pretty soon. Okay, today I don't have a comrade to help me, so basically all you do is off the bleeder, you remove this rubber cap, you put this hose on, and then you unscrew the bleeder, and slowly but surely the fluid will dribble out. You see how it's dribbling? Until it comes out clear. Okay, I started off with the driver's wheel. Keep in mind, you only work one wheel at a time, and you always monitor the reservoir, so you never let the reservoir go below min, okay? If it's starting to get low, just top it off, but top it off at every single wheel, okay?
You can see the fluid starting to come out. Just a little more. Don't go too much. Don't get too greedy. Normally I have my friend help me, but he's mad at me today, so there will be no helps.
You can see I undid the bolt, now I'm just gently finessing it around until the fluid comes out.
Luckily you can see it's turning clear pretty quickly.
I'm taking off the dust cover right now for the bleeder bolt on the passenger front side. Now I'm going to loosen the bleeder screw so that the fluid flows out. I'll just let it drip. Look how much clearer that fluid is now.
Just dribbling, dribbling, dribbling. I'm pretty satisfied with that, so then all you have to do is take your 11 millimeter and tighten it.
Keep in mind, after tightening these bolts, I went over and I torqued them all with a torque wrench to 18 Newton meters. Okay, keep in mind, after you're done with this, you want to check that your reservoir is, your brake fluid is at the max line. You want to replace the little screen and tighten your cap. And then before you, you want to start your car, and before you take it out of park, make sure you test your brake a few times to make sure that it feels right, okay? Keep in mind, this service costs roughly $230 at the dealer. So it's up to you. If you feel comfortable doing it, by all means do it. You know, you can take the risk. If you have never done it before, do it maybe with a friend, or just go to the dealer and have them do it. It's up to you. Anyway, I hope you learned something new today, and thanks for watching.